Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to add sequential numbers to tickets in InDesign using Google Sheets and InDesign's data merge feature. Now, the cool thing about this is after we're done, you can cut the tickets and they'll still be in order. So let's say you have four tickets on a page. If you cut it and cut it, cut it, cut it, then these, if you stack them up, they'll all still be in order, if that makes sense. All right, let's get started. Now, before we jump in, I want to let you know that normally you don't have to do this yourself. You can send a ticket off to a printing company and they will impose it and put however many up on a page. They will cut them all and do everything for you. So you might want to check with your printing company before you go to the trouble of doing this. But if you do have to do it, here's how. Okay, so I'm here in Adobe Illustrator and I've got this ticket set up exactly how I want. So if I hit Shift O, we can see that the width is 3.75 inches and my height is 1.87 inches. And if you're not seeing this bar up here at the top, you can just go to Window Control right here. Okay, now I need to get crop marks on this. So I'm going to hit Shift Command S. That's Shift Control S on a PC, and you can go to File, Save As to get to that too. I'm going to save this as a PDF to get my crop marks, and we'll go ahead and save. I'll come down here to marks and bleeds, and then I want trim marks, and I don't have any bleeds on this document, so I'm going to uncheck this. But if you have them, definitely check this. And each of these should be 0.125 or 3 millimeters. But since I don't have any, I'm going to leave those off and we'll save the PDF. Now, if we go out here and look at this, we can see that the crop marks have been added. Okay, now we'll create a new file in InDesign, and we're going to place a lot of tickets on one page. I'm going to go to New File. We'll come up here to Print, Letter. I don't want facing pages, so I'll uncheck that, but everything else looks good. I'll go ahead and change this to inches. Okay, we'll create. Now we'll place one of the tickets by going to File, Place. And I'm just going to click once to get it in there at full size. Now I'm going to click and drag while holding Shift and Option to make a copy, or Shift and Alt on a PC. Now I want these two crop marks to line up together, so we only have to cut once between them. Okay, and this is looking good. I'm going to kind of center this up on the page, and we'll group this with Command G or Control G. Now I'm going to click and drag while holding Shift and Option again to make a copy again. And I'll just keep doing that until I have the whole page filled up. Okay, so we have 10 tickets on here now. And I'm going to save this document. So I'll go to File, Save As. And I'll put this with the PDF. I'll call it Tickets. And we'll save. Now we'll go to Google Sheets, and I've opened a new spreadsheet. In the cell A1, we'll want to put the title of the first ticket. So I'm just going to call this one Ticket 1. In B1, I'll put Ticket 2, and we'll need to do this for all 10 tickets on that page. I'll highlight Ticket 1 and Ticket 2 cells, and then I'm going to get right in the corner here until I get this plus sign, and then click and drag all the way over here. Okay, and that got me to ticket 11, which I don't need. I only need 10 tickets. You'll need a column for every single ticket that you have on your page. Now let's say we want 280 tickets. So we'll need to divide that by 10, and that gives us 28. So in the first column, we'll put numbers 1 through 28. So I'll put 1 and 2 here. Now I want these to be 6 digits, so I'm going to select both of them. And I'll come up here to Format, Number, and then here's a 6 digits one. If you're not seeing the one you want, you can come down here to Custom Number Format and make your own style of number. But we'll just use this one right here. Now I'm also going to copy these down until we hit 28. So I'll select both of them. I'll get right on that lower right-hand corner, and I'll just click and drag until we get down there. Okay, and here's 28. So that's good. I'm going to delete these bottom two. Now for ticket 2, I want to start with number 29. So I'll do the same thing here. I'll put 29 and 30. I'll change my number format to 6 digits and then I'll just drag this down to here. Now that we have these two columns populated, we can select all of the digits in the first two, not the words ticket though, and then get on the bottom right hand corner here until you get the plus sign, click and drag all the way over to ticket 10. So now we have 280 tickets. The next step is to download this file as a CSV file. So go to File, Download, and then comma separated values or CSV. And this is going to come to our downloads folder. Instead of keeping it in there, I just went ahead and put it in the other folder. So now I'm going back to InDesign. I'm going to zoom in and I'm going to put the code in two places. I want it right here and right here. I'm going to draw a text box right here. I'm going to make it pretty big so that it can hold all six digits easily. And then I'll come up to Window, Utilities, and Data Merge. This Data Merge window actually gives you instructions on how to do this, but we don't really need that because I'm going to teach you that. So click on these three little lines and choose Select Data Source. And then navigate to that sheet you downloaded as the CSV file. We'll choose Open. And this is ticket one, so I'm going to choose ticket one here. And then I'm going to select all to highlight everything in there. And I don't like this font at all, so I'm going to change it to Montserrat. We'll do Montserrat bold. And I also want it uppercase, so I'm going to come up here to the top and choose all caps. Now this is too big, so I'm going to make it a little bit smaller by hitting Shift Command and left caret, that's above the comma. That's Shift Control left caret on a PC. You can do the right and left carets to make it bigger or smaller. You can also change the color here. Maybe we'll find out what that red is and make it red. So I'll come back here to Illustrator. I'll use my A tool, the direct selection, to select this red text and double click here. And then I'll copy this code and then go back to InDesign. I'll double click my text and I'll paste the code and say okay. So now this red should match this red. I would normally eyedropper this red here in InDesign, but since it's a place document, InDesign does not like that. So that's why I went back to Illustrator. Okay, so we have ticket one here. I'm just going to copy this and paste. I'll put this right over here, get near a corner, and then just hold shift and rotate it. And we'll kind of center it up in the space. Now I'm going to select both of these and copy. I'll come over here to ticket two and paste. I'll get back on my text tool and I'll highlight that ticket one text. And I'm going to come over here to my data merge window and choose ticket two. And I'll do the same here. I'm going to go ahead and select all of these tickets and lock them with Command L or Control L. Now I can select the text I just added really easily. I'll click on that, hold Shift and Option, and bring them down to the next two tickets. And then we'll go through that same process of changing the ticket numbers. And then finally, I'll do the last two. Some things are looking a little off-center, but this is just a tutorial, so take your time and make sure everything looks good, of course. For example, all of these right here seem a little high, so I'm going to select all of those and just move them down a little bit. Now we have all 10 tickets with the correct ticket numbers on them. Now we can come back to the Data Merge window and choose Create Merge Document, this little button right here. So I'll click that. We want to merge all records and we want a single record per page because we already have this all set up. We don't need InDesign to try to, you know, add more to a page or something like that. Okay, so we'll say okay. And depending on how many tickets you have, this might take a while. And it looks like it worked really well. So we have ticket one here. If we go to page two, we have ticket two. Page three, ticket three. If we start over and we look at this third coupon, it starts on 57 and we have 58 and 59. So if you print all these out and you cut this one out, those are all going to be in order. So after you've cut everything, you'll want to put this stack on top of this stack, on top of this stack, on top of this stack, like that. I would just go through and do a run through of all the pages. There should be 28 if you have 280 coupons. If everything looks good, you can export as a PDF. So go to File, Export, and I'll call this one Tickets 10 Up. And we want this to be a PDF for print. And we'll save. And if I don't have bleeds, I usually just do press quality. And we'll export. And here's the PDF with 28 pages of tickets to be printed. So that's it. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.